we begin the fourth day of the Novena in honor to celebrate the birthday of our Mother Mary, we are invited to look at the services provided by the sanitation workers. Sanitation workers provide an invaluable public service vital to our daily lives and the cleaning of in and around our environment. Yet, they often work in conditions that expose them to the worst consequences of life by the government by providing poor facilities for sanitation workers, debilitating infections, injuries, social stigma, and even deaths. Sanitation workers are out in full force to keep us healthy and keep India and our surrounding swatch. Even as the COVID-19 crisis continues to impact the country, the spread of this virus is on top of other serious challenges to all and especially to the sanitation workers. Today, as we focus on Mary being the caregiver who gave birth to Jesus in a manger, let us ask Mary, our mother, to implore on us the graces that we and the sanitation workers need so that we too can imbibe good qualities in our daily lives and make our world to be better and cleaner. Let us pray for all those who are involved in sanitation works and services for their health, safety and dignity.
My work might be disgusting, but I always keep myself clean. I do not have any bad habits. I don't drink alcohol. I always wash myself thoroughly after work and before eating or drinking anything. These days, everyone asks us to use safety gear, particularly shoes and gloves. But you cannot work wearing those. It is not easy to get into or climb out of the pits if we wear shoes or gloves. I have never had any health problems or accidents. However, I do know of people who have died during sewer cleaning. One of the people I know was inside a manhole trying to unblock it. As soon as he unblocked it, the manhole started to fill up. Fortunately, his friends were standing above the ground right outside the manhole. They pulled him out before he drowned.
In India, sanitation has seen a major push in recent times. But you know what people still ignore? Sanitation workers, a historically designated and socially invisible class of human labor. They are around 5 million full-time workers, where 2.5 million routinely face high occupational hazards. Over 90% are the lowest Dalit subcastes, and around 60 to 70% are urban workers, 50% of whom are women. Sanitation workers clean railway stations, sewers and septic tanks, sewage treatment plants, open drains and roads, community toilets and dry latrines, and school and domestic toilets. They work in unhealthy and hazardous conditions for very little money and with no insurance. Imagine a job for which you are socially ostracized, have no mobility prospects, and expect to die at 50. Well, sanitation work was historically considered the job of people condemned to it. The best way to end that assumption is to focus on how we can bring people within this ecosystem into a better today.
Let us reflect on the health, safety, and dignity of sanitation workers. Sanitation workers bear the multiple stigma of offensive and unclean work, low wages, undignified and highly dangerous form of employment that results in long-term health problems and a high risk of death too. They also deal with human excreta and waste from the human body. They have to breathe in and bear the foul smell, which is at times unbearable. Yet, they did not back out during these most crucial times of the pandemic. Some had no choice, while some others did it out of love and concern for humanity. In today's scripture, we reflect how Jesus had no place in the inn. He was born and laid in a manger. Usually, a newborn baby needs a clean, hygiene surrounding. Here, the Son of God was laid among the animals. Probably, there may have been droppings of the animals, the unbearable smell of the unclean stable, the germs, or even worms could have caused any infection to the newborn baby and the mother.
Yet, amidst the unhygienic situation, the Son of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, overcame the high risk of infection and diseases because He Himself was the sanitizer who cleanses the unclean spirits, our hearts, sinful desires, unwanted hurts and resentment, jealousy and pride from people of God. Jesus, with His humble birth in the stable, overcame shame, sickness and death. He is the sanitizer, the cleanser of our souls. But before He entered His work life and ministry as a law-abiding Jew, His mother, Mary, already played her part. Like any mother, when faced with no option, Mary would have done her bit to sanitize and clean as much as possible, so that she could give birth to a son in a cleaner place in that stable. Let us then offer to the Lord our unclean hearts and minds, our negativity which does not allow us to experience the love of God, and learn to live a dignified and pure life like Mary our mother, and respect every human health, safety and dignity of life.
Given by our Father's hand. Let us recite the novena prayer together. O most holy Virgin, you were chosen to be the mother of Jesus. Permit me, your devoted client, to praise you for this unique privilege. O tender mother and comfortress of the afflicted, grant me the special protection which you have promised to those who venerate you. Relying on the infinite mercies of your divine Son, trusting on his promises that those who ask would receive, and penetrated with confidence in your powerful intercession, I most humbly entreat you to obtain for me the favors which I petition for in this novena, if it is the holy will of God, or else whatever graces I most stand in need of. Kindly place your request. In veneration of the love and joy with which your heart was replenished when the Word was made flesh in your womb, I offer you the sentiments of my heart. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
O Mother of God, accept these salutations in union with the veneration with which the angel Gabriel first hailed you, full of grace. I wish most sincerely that these may become so many gems in the crown of your celestial glory. Mother Mary, to your keeping, soul and body we confine, toiling, resting, walking, sleeping, be you ever at our side. Cares that vexes, joys that pleases, life and death, we trust in you. You make yours all for Jesus and for all eternity. Amen.
Rejoice and come in. Today will be a joyful day. Enter, rejoice and come in. Lift up your hearts to the Lord. Lift up your hearts to the Lord. Today will be a joyful day. Lift up your hearts to the Lord.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, today we are in the fourth day of our novena in honor to our loving mother, Mother Mary. Today we specially pray for all the sanitized warriors or workers. We pray for their family members and the services that they render to each one of us. And also, we remember and pray for the soul of Connie Pinto, and also remembrance of the birthday for the soul of Rosie Vergis. And place before the Lord all the prayers our heart's desires as we partake in this novena. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, have mercy on your people gathered here. Christ, have mercy on your people gathered here. We confess we have sinned in thought and word and deed. Lord, have mercy on your people gathered here.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in unfailing health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, our Virgin, may we be set free from the present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brethren, from the day we heard your love in the Spirit, we have not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him, bearing fruit in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, being strengthened with all power according to His glorious might, for all endurance and patience with joy, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified you to share in this inheritance of the saints in light. He has delivered us from the kingdom, from the domain of darkness, and transferred us to the kingdom of His beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. The word of Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response shall be, the Lord has made known His salvation. Altogether.
the Lord has made known his salvation.
The Lord has made known his salvation, has shown his deliverance to the nations. He has remembered his merciful love and his truth for the house of Israel. Your response?
The Lord has made known his salvation.
All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our Lord. Shout to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing out your praise. Your response?
The Lord has made known his salvation.
Sing psalms to the Lord with the harp and the sound of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Raise with a shout before the King, O Lord. Your response?
The Lord has made known his salvation.
Please rise for the gospel.
According to St. Luke,
glory be to you, O Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descendant from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in the bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, as we are in the fourth day upon Novena in honor to celebrate the birthday of our Mother Mary, we are invited to look at the services provided by sanitization workers. It is through our work that we develop and express ourselves, support our families, and enrich our communities and earn our livelihood. Work is therefore a fundamental dimension of our existence on earth. In today's novena, let us resolve to work towards bringing order and dignity to the presently chaotic world of work. Let us pray for the health, safety, and the dignity of sanitization warriors as we consider them as a frontline warriors of today's world. We take inspiration from the Holy Family of Mary, holding the home together, of Saint Joseph the Worker and his son, and trainee Jesus the Carpenter, who upheld the dignity of human work. We are at a time of choice to appreciate and honor our sanitization warriors through our spiritual support at the time of COVID-19 pandemic. Let us choose to build a world where work is a right and duty of all. Everyone's dignity is valued and respected, whether they are sanitization workers or daily laborers. May the Holy Spirit bless our efforts, protect and guide every one of us to take care of our Mother Earth and have dignity of human labor. Dear friends, as we celebrate this fourth day of novena, we have many things to pray for, especially the sanitization workers or warriors, and also our personal prayers. Let us place before the Lord all our prayers.
Arishavan Salbi, to the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayers.
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayers.
For our Pope, Bishop, Priest, Deacons, and all religious, that they may be strengthened by the Holy Spirit in their preaching the good news of salvation. Arishavan Salbi,
through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, we pray for the workers who take care of us by sanitizing our areas and taking care of our health so that we can live in safe conditions. We also know that by doing so, they are putting their lives at risk. We pray for their safety and well-being. Your response?
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for the poor, the homeless, the unemployed, and those who live without life's basic necessities. May they be blessed with comfort, hope, and healing. Your response?
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for those who are sick and ailing with the coronavirus, and that vaccine may be made available to all people so that suffering and pain are eased. We also lift up those who have lost their loved ones because of this pandemic. Give them strength to bear their loss. Your response?
Through the intercession of Mother Mary, Lord, hear our prayers.
In the silence of our heart, Let us place before our loving mother all the prayers. Lord Heavenly Father, you have blessed us with human dignity. We as loving children of our Mother Mary may, inspired by her life, that we may be able to serve others and protect the right of every citizen. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gifts we bring, listen to the prayer we sing, sanctify our sacrifice from heaven above. Draw us close to you, we pray, by the bread we give this day. May we this great mystery of
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we ask, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered, no request be made in vain, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo a thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's end, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the loveliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adore your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise, as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, earth and heaven are filled with your glory. He is blessed who comes in the name of the Lord. Sing, Hosanna in the highest, praise the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your holy church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Especially we pray for the soul of Connie Pinto and soul of Rosie Verghese. And also let us remember and pray for the departed souls in our family. During this pandemic time, many sanitization warriors have lost their life. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, our most chaste spouse, St. Vincent Pilotti, and all the saints, we have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Dear friends, our journey with our loving mother has been a graceful one. Let us pray for all the graces, especially our family members need in this time of COVID-19 pandemic. Let us ask through the intercession of our Blessed Mother as we say the prayer that Jesus himself taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Dear friends, this is the same Jesus who sanitized the world through his blood and who took away the sins of all of us. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
O Lord Jesus, since I cannot receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament Most Holy, O Sacrament Divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to his side. With love and strength for each new day. He will make a way. cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side, with love and strength for each new day.
Blessed is the womb of the Virgin Mary, which bore the Son of the Eternal Father. Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mysteries of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear friends, today's liturgy is conducted by the Confirmation Group, so we would like to thank all the confirmation catechists, Deacon Ivan, Rowena, Tina, Zinia, and Janice, and all the students who took part in this celebration. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
No man can live as an to Jesus, your loving Son. Come with us, Mary, come. When Jesus met with rejection, Mary stood by the cross. How can a mother desert a son? She'll also stand by us. Be with Mary along the way, guide every step we take. Lead us to Jesus, your loving Son. Come with us, Mary, come. Come with us, Mary, come with us, Mary.